A very good morning to all of you guys. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So guys, before moving on to the first question of the day, let me inform you that you can download the PDF of this session on the Telegram channel, and the link of our Telegram channel is in description below. So now let's begin with our first question. So I hope that majority of you must have already heard about this news, and even if you don't have heard about this news, then it's very I would say good for me, because I have brought to you this question in the first place only in order to make you understand the implications of being added into the UNESCO Creative Cities Network. What is this network all about, and what all cities from India are there in this network? So all of these we are going to cover in this question. So recently, Srinagar has been added into the UNESCO Creative Cities Network in Folk Art and Craft category. With this, India now has a total of 6 cities in this network. Which city from the following UCCN, that is UNESCO Creative Cities Network, is accompanying Srinagar in the Folk Art and Craft category from India basically? So we have Chennai, Varanasi, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Jaipur. All of these are the 5 cities which were already there, and joining them is Srinagar. So now we have 6 UNESCO Creative Cities in India. Now, which city has been listed in this network in the category of folk art and craft? So here the right answer is Jaipur. Okay, so you will understand this better once we discuss the UNESCO Creative Cities Network. But before moving into the Creative Cities Network, I would like to tell you about the news itself, okay? So Srinagar, which is the summer capital of Jammu and Kashmir, so Srinagar has joined this UNESCO Creative Cities Network, and do remember it is the only city this year that has got a place in this network. A total of 49 cities from across the world have been added into this network, and Srinagar is the only city from India among those 49 cities. Now, along with Srinagar, Gwalior was also recommended for inclusion, but it was not included. Only Srinagar has been included. Now, which other cities we have in this list? Chennai and Varanasi have been added in the category of music. Jaipur is in the category of crafts and folk art, for which Srinagar is also added. Mumbai is the UNESCO city of film. Hyderabad is the city of gastronomy. So for the preview only, you can just understand this thing that we have these many cities as the UNESCO Creative Cities in India. Now, you need to understand this network in order to understand this entire thing, that why are the cities classified as the city of music, as the city of film, as the city of gastronomy, etc., etc. So let's move into the details of this network, which is a very important initiative from UNESCO's part. Okay, so this was launched in 2004, and right now, as I have told you, that 49 cities have been added. So the total number of cities that this list has now is 295 from 90 countries. Obviously, that includes India as well. Now, this list categorizes cities into different categories, which are craft and folk art, design, film, gastronomy, literature, media arts, and music. Okay, so these are the categories in which cities are divided in this list. Now here, which cities are added into the list? So basically, the cities that promote creativity as well as culture both in their urban cities. Basically, the cities that have a very good mix of creativity and culture, particularly those cities are selected into this list in order to promote creativity among the other cities. So basically, Srinagar and all the cities that are there in this list will now share their best practices in their respective fields. For example, Srinagar is in folk art and craft. So they will share their best practices and promote their creativity as well as culture. So the overall aim of this list is to encourage creativity in urban development. So that is the basic purpose. Why do you provide any accolade or any recognition to anything? Just to give them encouragement so that they do better. So similarly, the cities that are classified in this network are being given encouragement so that they boost their creativity, so that the cities have a uniqueness in themselves. Next question is, what is India's rank in the Global Drug Policy Index 2021? So here, India's rank is 80. Now let me tell you that only 30 countries were assessed in this index. So out of 30, India is at the 18th rank. Now this index has been released by a consortium, which is named as Harm Reduction Consortium. It is basically a consortium of different international anti-drug organizations. A total of 30 countries, as I have told you. Norway is the first, Brazil is the last. As you would know that Central America is very infamous for drugs, okay? Parameters of this index are a total of 75 indicators, which are divided into these domains. Absence of extreme response, proportionality and criminal justice, harm reduction, access to medicines, development. So these were the parameters. And guys, as you can see, this is the list of top 10 countries. So clearly Norway is at the top, New Zealand, Portugal, UK, Australia, Canada, Georgia, North Macedonia, Costa Rica, Senegal. So these are the top 10 countries. Now you don't have to memorize all of them. Just keep in mind Norway. Okay, that would do for your examination. Next is India's rank. So India is at the 18th rank, which you can see here. Now the overall score of India is 46. This you need to remember. Apart from this, even if you would not remember these scores in different parameters, then also it would do for your preparation, because the major reason behind this is that this index has not been released by a very prominent organization. Therefore, there are very less chances that a question would be made from this index. However, you cannot ignore it, right? So from the exam perspective, in my opinion, ranking of India and the overall score would suffice your preparation. Next question is, where will Tribal Pride Day Mahasammelan be organized? So here the right answer is Madhya Pradesh. Now guys, apart from this Tribal Day Mahasammelan, there is another important news from this entire news only. So that is that Prime Minister will attend this Mahasammelan and inaugurate India's first PPP mode based Habibganj railway station, public-private partnership mode based Habibganj railway station in Madhya Pradesh. So do remember this news as well. Now on whose birthday do we celebrate the tribal state? So it is on Birsa Munda's birthday, okay, who was a very famous tribal. Next is World Radiology Day is observed on November 8 every year to mark the anniversary of the discovery of X-rays in 1895. Who discovered X-rays? So here the right answer is Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen. So World Radiology Day is observed on November 8, so do remember the date. Now this day is observed to mark the discovery of the X-rays, which was first discovered by the German scientist Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen in 1985. Later on, he got the Nobel Prize for this discovery as well. Now, what is the theme of this day in 2021? Interventional radiology, active care for the patient. So that was all about this day. Which city is hosting ISOCARP's 57th World Planning Congress 2021? So here the right answer is Doha. Now guys, before moving on to this news further, let me tell you that Doha was also included among the 49 cities that have been added into UNCCN. Doha from Qatar, Jakarta from Indonesia. So Doha's category is design, Jakarta's category is literature, and similarly, there are 49 cities. How many will you remember along with their categories? So that is the thing that examiner also understands. Therefore, the examiner is not going to put up any question which is not very relevant, which is from a city that is in the dark, okay? But still, Doha is a very important city because Doha is also going to host the FIFA World Cup in 2022. Therefore, a question can be made on Doha as well. So do remember, in design category, Doha has been added into the UNESCO Creative Cities Network. Now, why are we discussing this World Planning Congress? The reason behind this is that World Urbanism Day. Again, we discussed the Creative Cities Network. So obviously, we were highlighting the urban cities. In the light of this news, this day is also important, okay? So World Town Planning Day is also observed on November 8th by International Society of City and Regional Planners. And this organization is going to hold or organize the 57th World Planning Congress in Doha, Qatar. And the theme of the Congress is Planning Unlocked, new times, better places, stronger communities. So this is the theme of this World Planning Congress. Now the last question is, West Indies cricketer Dwayne Bravo has announced retirement from international cricket. Which country does he belong? So all of these are the island nations of the West Indies area. The right answer here is Trinidad and Tobago. So he's the player. He has announced his retirement and he belongs to Trinidad. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have liked the content that I provided to you. So if you liked it, then do subscribe our channel. Thank you so much for watching the video.